making chocolates. And not only chocolates, but the ones I was so used to in Belgium chocolates, and which I couldn't find here, so I decided to start a business to make chocolate the Belgian way, Belgian style. A good chocolate, you should see it by the sheen, it's like satin. You can also hear a good chocolate. It has to snap like a dead brown when you break it. And then the taste and the texture, everything is included when you see a good chocolate. What we try to do is taking the bean as is without adding too much to it. Second thing is that makes the Belgian chocolate quality is the recipe we put in it. Because you make your shell first, then you have to put a recipe inside. So we use the recipe as a base, the Belgian recipe, and I kind of add flavors to it, or I add whatever is needed to make it taste good. That's our strength too. We customize everything. You bring your own wine or liqueur, we will put that, we will flavor our chocolate with it. So weddings, you have your wine set, we use that wine to make our chocolates. Easton, to me, is booming and I feel it. There's so many artists there, great restaurants, there is the feeling like New York. I don't know how to explain that either, but that's what attracts me so much. And the people I interact with other vendors, the artists, the restaurant holders, it clicks. Having the good chocolate from a good origin, eventually even from an area like the wines, you go to terroirs, you have a specific family plantation where you get your beans, they're grinded. I don't do that, I don't do bean to chocolate. I do chocolate to whatever you will see in the store. Then it comes in, you have to temper it. Second, you have to make your recipe, which is secret. Third, you have to pipe it in, and then you have to cap it off. Always with tempered chocolate the whole time, and if you fail, do it again. Then you have the truffle. That's the naked truffle. We want it to look even better. What we do is, we have painters here, we do nothing else but painting with butter on the chocolates. Then you have the packaging. So this is a long process before you get to an end product where we, and we have quality controls here, I can assure you, where we are happy enough to make to satisfy the customer. The art of chocolate requires all your senses, and I think that's true for all artists. But all your senses to work together and make that perfect product. I think that's the art of chocolate.